SOS, yes. I learned that in the Navy.
Happy New Year, everyone.
Happy New Year, you fuckers. Have you made any resolutions? Oh yes, we're wearing hats now. Sorry, I forgot. My new resolution is to call you fuckers, not bastards. Yes. This is my wife. We're still married.
Hi. I'm Megan.
Yes.
Like the cow, you know, with the chocolates.
Yes, and the donkeys.
Yeah.
Mm.
You know, yes. The purple chocolate.
Yes. With the gear sticks. Yes. Mm-hmm. So we're in the vehicle. That's all I'm going to say.
We can't really drive, but we're still on it.
Yes, we're waiting for our driver to come and take us home. But he's apparently on lockdown, so he might be here for a moment. But we're saying cheers. Do you have anything to say cheers with, or are we sharing? Yes, see? That's the secret of a good marriage.
Actually, my husband, it's, you know, he's like half reptilian, so we don't know how it's going to affect him, but it's still, you know, it's okay.
I'm a snake inside.
Yeah, so, yeah.
But only on the inside. Yes. So, Happy New Year. What are we going to tell them?
Happy New Year, everyone. I'm so excited for you.
We came to open a bar because we're royal and it's closed. So, yes, that was a mistake. But we learn, don't we?
Yeah.
Yes.
We do.
Yes. And it's good to be able to learn without any, what do they call it? You know, when there's no danger of, if you make a mistake, it doesn't matter because no one can do anything.
Is this in British accent?
Who?
Because I don't really understand what you're trying to say.
Yes, well, we're trying to train Megan up as quickly as possible with the old British accent, but we're in America. Via Bulgaria, via somewhere else. So, yes, really as a royal, she should speak a little bit more educated. But I don't know.
I think,
what's happening to my voice. Now, come on now, let's be serious. We're filming to these people here.
What are we doing in here?
I don't know, but it's a trend. We're a trend, apparently. We trended.
Trend what?
I don't know what that means. But apparently it means we should make another video.
I just, you know, I have a message for all these people, you know, up there.
Tell them.
Because...
Tell them.
You know, I'm so emotional and I'm so compassionate. Okay. And I'm so great and I'm so kind. Or at least that's what I think I am. So
I agree with what you think you are.
I forgot what I was about to say. What was I about to say?
Hold on, it doesn't matter. What was I going to say? Yes, it doesn't matter. Yes, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if we remember, because nothing bad can happen to us.
Yes, I remember.
I remember what I was trying to say
to people. It's, you know, we're out and we're not wearing masks because, you know, my husband, he's half reptilian.
Yes.
He's not really human, so we don't know in what way, you know, the COVID would affect him.
Only the bottom half.
Yeah, so I really want to see how this is going to affect him. Mm-hmm. And I even, you know, practiced my lines for his funeral, if he dies.
Mm.
Yes, and we, you know, with my royal stylist, we even picked a dress for me to wear at his funeral if he dies.
Yes. Yes, she looks bloody gorgeous. You know? And everyone's going to be like, oh, ho, ho, I wish I was him. Not dead, which, you know.
Yes, so I just want to say to all the people concerned about me out there, because I know you really care about me and the way I feel about things and the way I am. So So I just wanted to know that we came up with a plan for what is going to happen if Harry dies.
Hmm. Yes, Meghan has a plan.
So we planned that we are going to divorce him from, divorce his brother with his wife. And I don't think she really likes me because I'm black and I'm obviously much more beautiful than she is. So.
Well, yes. But,
yeah.
But actually, so speaking of divorce, all you fuckers who keep talking about us being divorced and... who do you think you are? That's so, all I've got to say. Who do you think you are? Who do they think they are?
They didn't really...
Did they not see the wedding that we had?
Honey, they don't really care about what you have to say. They're here because they want to hear what I'm going to say, so shut the fuck up.
Yes, but you can't divorce a royal wedding. You can't. You can't, because it's institutionalized.
Yes, and this...
And she will not divorce me, because she gets too much when I die.
So we talked about this.
Right?
And by divorce, we meant deceased. So, we're going to be just two widowers, you know.
Yes, yes, finding, of course, that's a different word. Yes.
Finding, you know, love after the death of our loved ones, so...
Mm, yes, it will be still, like yeah, that fairy tale. You know the one?
Yeah, so we have a plan.
Yes, well, she's already dragged me across the pond, hasn't she? And played the old race card against my whole family. You know, I'm a bit of a maverick, aren't I? So, at the moment, I'm not sure if I'm being honest when I care, or if I'm just playing some kind of little role, a little game to make my life interesting. But either way, apparently,
do you know with,
I'm going to die quite soon. So,
do you know, with royal people, it's honesty, it's something that... they will never know.
No.
Because, you know, they were born hypocrites. It's just in their blood.
We have no reference.
And this is the exact reason that I happen to be a very good wife of yours.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah. Yes, because my dearest, she also doesn't give a shit, you know.
But I know.
From a different place. From a different place.
But I know how to look like I do give a shit.
Yes.
And this is very difficult on me.
Yes, and I'm trying to learn.
People think it's easy, but it's actually not.
Mm.
No, it's not. Mm. Pretending to care all the time is just exhausting.
Yes.
Isn't it?
It's true. But the thing is, this is why we're such a good team. Because the thing is she has the disability of being American, you know. So her giving a shit... it doesn't really fly outside of her own, you know, silly Billy American sleuth who believe all of that kind of gibberish. So yes, this is where I come in, and I add a little bit of, right? She gives a little bit of the wah, and I go the hmm. And together that's dangerous.
I want to share something with our fans because I think they're going to appreciate it.
I think so.
I want to share that we have our own garden and we grow our own carrots together, me and Harry.
Yes.
Just the two of us.
I know. Could you imagine that?
Harry loves them carrots, really. He just is in love with them.
Well, yes.
And it's really amazing for me to see how they affect him.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
He likes them. He really enjoys them.
I don't know where that comes from. It must be in my genes. Don't you think? Yeah. It's one of the reasons why... anyway, that's a private story, isn't it? You know, how
he
we met.
He names the carrots we grow. All of them just have a name. And it's really fascinating. It's just amazing.
Well, who wouldn't? Who wouldn't? Who wouldn't name a carrot if they'd watched it grow from such a little tender tender seed in the ground.
Until they become, you know, just huge, enormous carrots.
Well, some of them do, some of them don't. But it's not about the size of the carrot in the ground. It's about the taste that can be found within its... I don't know.
Yeah, I know, but you said it's all about the size. And you made me just give the small carrots to the poor because we're generous.
People. Yes.
Yeah, we just like to donate and
yes.
Be kind to things for, you know, the poor people and just be great.
Well, yes, you know, because basically when you're giving to charity, they count the number of carrots you give, not the size of the carrot. So the thing is, you can give one large carrot and it could be worth at least three or four of the smaller carrots. But the thing is, you give three or four smaller carrots and then you times that by 100. You give them 300 or 400 carrots to the poor and people are like, oh my gosh, aren't you the greatest? If you say, oh, well, I only gave 10 big carrots, they were like, well, you know, who cares? So it's all a question of, anyway, it's carrot maths, carrot currency.
Yeah, I know, honey, but now we're talking about us and about the things you like.
Well, carrot honey, I tell you what, that sounds very, very exciting. Is that a thing, or can we make it a thing?
Hey. By the way, I just want to share another very exciting thing that is going to happen. Me and Harry are going to participate in the biggest carrot competition. You know, our most, you know, enormous carrot is going to participate, you know, and hopefully we will win.
What, John or Peter?
Come on, honey, don't pretend you don't know.
They're currently, you know, it's some people say John and some people say Peter. It depends on whether you're judging, you know, this or this.
You know what we're talking about, Maximus Prime. Come on.
Well,
it's your favorite one.
MP, yes. Well, MP, where are we? Wait, what are we entering MP for?
A competition. You said you were going to participate in the competition, the biggest carrot in the world.
Oh, yes.
Hopefully they will put our carrot into the Guinness record.
Oh, well, they have no choice because I'll put my people onto it and they're the ones who... Anyway, we're breaking records. That's all they need to know out there, you fuckers. Yes, don't think I forgot my New Year's resolution. And do you... Look at this.
By the way, we want to share something else.
Yes.
I know it's going to be very, very shocking, but I like being shocking.
You do, don't you?
Yes, yes. I just enjoy, you know,
making the headlines. Electricity.
It's something about making the headlines, you know, being on the cover of magazines. That really excites me.
Mm-hmm.
So I just wanted to say
Are we making a call? Sorry?
I just wanted to say that me and Harry... I forget what I was going to say again.
Pornography? We're not making pornography. We're going to have another baby.
No. You know, the thing is with Harry and me, because I'm black and Harry is, you know, reptilian, and we, with our children, because our firstborn was a black mamba, so we had to donate it to the zoo.
Yes.
And it's really, really, really challenging with having, you know, our own offspring. So it's really difficult. It's really difficult.
Yes, I think of that black mamba every now and then.
You know, she was a huge baby.
Yes.
We wanted to keep her so much, but...
They wouldn't let us.
Yeah.
When I say they, I mean we wouldn't let ourselves keep it dangerous for the children.
No, we actually thought of keeping it, but then we thought about kindergarten and, you know, just sending it to school, and we decided it's going to be really tough on us.
Yeah, and I didn't know the reptile was so strong within genetics, you know. So for the next one, I calmed it down a little bit.
By the way, we name it Optimus Prime after my husband's favorite carrot.
Yes. Yes, the prime part.
Yeah.
We didn't want to double up on the Maximus. You know, Maximus would have got jealous. And the carrot, so what comes first, the carrot or the child? Well, was it a snake? No, no, carrot or the snake, what came first?
It was the carrot, that's why we kept it.
Yes, yes, and the thing is carrots are easier to look after, aren't they? And they're less dangerous. But...
So we were before a very difficult choice.
Yes.
Whether to keep our child or the carrot.
If it had just been the snake and the carrot, we would have kept them both because they're no danger to each other. But when you put a child in the middle, then all kinds of things can happen.
You know, our firstborn... And then just came the our baby. It was our baby's name.
I don't know, but I feel like we're revealing too much about ourselves and we should be making some more general statements that actually make people feel bad about themselves because they're not us.
Okay, I understand.
So you out there, look at how exciting our life is. Constantly, constantly.
But it's difficult, so... Yeah, you can feel sorry for us.
Yes, well, I sometimes feel sorry for Megan, and I believe that she's going to kill me one day.
What?
Because apparently she thinks that that's going to get her somewhere in this life. But
That's so not true.
If you kill a prince, then I don't think there's a worse crime in this world, and I don't even imagine what the punishment would be. But I wouldn't like to. I wouldn't like to. So I'm trying to stay alive just for that.
Harry, look at yourself.
Yes.
Look at yourself. You're not even Prince Charles's son.
Good.
So
look at him.
What kind of a prince are we talking about? A fake one?
Now, that's enough of that chat.
Let's talk about Corona.
Because if I'm not a prince, then what are you?
Let's talk about Corona. Let's talk about Corona.
Who?
Corona.
What's Corona?
I don't know, but they say it's something very big happening out there in the world. And I'm really concerned that it's really big.
Well, it's lucky we don't live out there in that world. We're here in a car. This is a corona-free zone.
That's not really our car. It's not really our car, and both of us, we can really drive.
The thing is in our position, nothing is ours, but everything is ours. You know? Should we swap hats?
Let's
swap hats, okay.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
You see, about, you know, marriage, everything is about sharing.
Yes. Give, we take, we share. So all of you out there, give something to somebody, and take something from somebody, share.
We don't know a lot about giving, but we can tell you a lot about getting, so...
Yes.
You have to do it.
Yes. So people give us things and then we share them with each other. Yes?
Yes.
Yes. And that's the spirit of Christmas?
Is it Christmas?
I think so.
Really?
I think that is the true spirit of Christmas. Don't
Merry
you think?
Merry Christmas, my love.
And Happy New Year to you.
Is it really a new year? What time is it?
I don't know. But it's enough with you. So we're going to turn off the lights, and who knows what will happen. But we love you.
We don't really.
No. Well, love means nothing to us. Words mean nothing to us.
But we care.